Hello, hello. Thank you. I hope you can all find your
5 million investment in our Nadi center, the tourism and hospitality center.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Isambul Bunan, and well, good afternoon to you all. Thank you indeed for the invitation to be here this afternoon. I always look forward to coming to Nadi. I was here a few weeks back for the crowning of the Bulo Festival, and of course I'm back here again today. So thank you indeed for the invitation. As I see in the program that I'm supposed to do an opening address and then talk to you about agriculture as well, perhaps I'll focus more on agriculture this afternoon. But as I've stated, always good to come back to Nadi because this is where I started my working career. When I left school, I did about 3.5 years with the Native Land Development Corporation. I think that was one of the first commercial farms in Fiji back then. But unfortunately, due to some financial problems, they have to close the operations, and most of these areas have been now developed into commercial lots and, of course, residential lots as well. You would recall the papaya plantation at the Masoso Junction, and of course the mango plantation where Jetsi is now, next to the research station in Lenalena. I used to drive tractors there when I left school. So I left the project and saw the advertisement in the papers, joined the army, traveled the world, and I didn't know that I was going to come back to agriculture. Agriculture is my passion, and I'm not only talking as a minister, but I'm a farmer as well. I do ginger farming, I do yams and barley, and I do sugarcane as well. I always believe in leading from the front, and I have to be involved in agriculture in order to convince people that agriculture is sexy. And this is one of the tasks that was given to me when I came into agriculture. Make sure that you make agriculture sexy again. So I'm going to talk about the benefits of agriculture this afternoon. Very quickly, ladies and gentlemen, let me just again acknowledge all of you on behalf of government. Government cannot function on its own. I wish to acknowledge all the stakeholders who are here, the landowners, the religious organizations, and particularly the private sector represented here by the Nadi Business Council. Thank you indeed. We all know and understand how important the role that the private sector plays in growing the economy and, of course, creating employment, bringing the foreign dollars, and, of course, the other benefits, socio-economic benefits that come with it. I do acknowledge the Indian High Commission, represented by the Second Secretary and, of course, the Minister for Forests, who is also here with us, the Honorable Nengabu. Nadi, as we all know, is strategic, and this is one of the reasons why I wanted to be here, because not only of the recent developments and those that are about to take place, but most importantly, looking at the potentials and the opportunities in the future. I always argue that we can shape our destiny together. And particularly when we talk about a preferred future in which we all have equal responsibility, and of course we need to take ownership of as well. So thank you once again for this privilege to be here with you this afternoon, and I hope that we will indeed have a very, very successful afternoon session, and of course I look forward to meeting most of you during the course of the events that are organized today. Let me go quickly to agriculture. Ladies and gentlemen, as you all know, agriculture is perhaps the backbone of the economy. Although we have been overtaken over the years by tourism and the other sectors, yesterday I had my whole team from Suva with me in the last 2 days, actually, just to look at, again, the plans that we have in the agriculture ministry, as we are preparing for the next financial year. But as I alluded to, it's the backbone of the economy, and we still employ a good number of Fijians, perhaps the majority of Fijians, although the performance over the years has sort of, particularly the contribution to GDP has dropped significantly. But I'm not here to defend agriculture, but I always justify the reasons behind the drop in the performance of the agriculture sector. Like any other developing state and the other sectors of the economy are performing and performing well, developing, agriculture definitely is one of the sectors that will pay the price. Rural to urban drift is a global phenomenon. People are shifting into urban areas, and as a result, particularly for those that live in rural areas and their livelihood is agriculture, this is one of the sectors that they live, and of course they go. We live in a benefit-oriented society, and this is why people are moving into the other sectors. If you look at the Fiji's economy as well, represented by the sector of pie, previously we only had about 8 to 10 sectors, but now it's more than 20-something sectors. And tourism back then was a small contributor to the economy because we were just picking up in tourism. But now it has overtaken the other sectors. Others have come on board as well. I'm just saying that, and I used to say this in Parliament, of course, a contribution to GDP overall is decreasing. But when you look at the figures, contribution to GDP, particularly with export levels, is increasing. I will not go to bore you with figures this afternoon because of. And then we have other issues as well. One of these is the politics of the past. Let's be honest with ourselves. Because of the politics of the past, land was politicized. And this is why the agriculture sector was one of the sectors that was badly affected. Lands were not renewed. It affected the sugar sector. It perhaps affected forestry and other sectors as well. But this is a history of the past. Most of our best brains left as well. We were quite competent in agriculture research. We had some very good scientists, both in the sugar and the non-sugar sector. But most of these best brains of ours have left. But I will not dwell much into the history of the past. But for our information, ladies and gentlemen, and this is perhaps where I want to focus in the next 10 minutes before I conclude. We all know and understand that for us, the government, Minister for Economy, always talks about broadening the economic base, and of course, agriculture has a significant role to play in these intentions, so that these intentions of government can be achieved. But let me go very quickly to some of the challenges before I talk about the opportunities and then conclude. We have a few challenges in agriculture. At the same time, I will be addressing what we have done about this. One, policy issues and regulations issues. We are living in a competitive, globalized world. But something that we noted lately when we joined agriculture, we are victims of some of the old policies and regulations that we have. Unfortunately, we cannot get some producers from other countries because of the old regulations that we have. Likewise, we cannot sell into other countries, let alone the planting materials and the genetic materials that we need to bring. Because most of what we have, or what we want to do, we have to seek the assistance of others. So, old regulations that we have, what have we done? In 2014, we identified the need for us to change the agriculture sector. So we launched the first policy paper, the 2020 Agriculture Sector Policy Agenda, which talks about what the main aim of the document is, the modernization of the agriculture sector. We need to modernize Fiji's agriculture sector so that it can be competitive, so that it can be relevant as well. And most importantly, provide and deliver to the expectations of the key stakeholders. One of the big challenges that we have, again, is the land tenure system as well. But I've talked about land being politicized, but government through the Land Utilization Committee has started working on renewing land leases, and not only renewal of land leases, but better utilization of the leases as well. Some leaseholders have land, but they are not fully utilized. This is a major concern, let alone the MCMT farmers. We have a lot of agriculture land in Fiji today, both with ILTP and Lands Department, where the land belongs to somebody who is not even here in Fiji. And it's vacant. I toured most of these areas with the Minister for Lands 2 weeks ago, and we perhaps will look at options in terms of our legislation so that we can utilize this land. There are some very good models that we have in other countries. So it's the land system which government is starting to work slowly towards so that we can fully utilize the land that we have. And then we have the challenges about infrastructure and utilities. This is one of the big lessons that we learned in agriculture when we came into the ministry. Agriculture ministry was only producer driven, production driven. We neglected the value chain and the supply chain. We all know and agree, ladies and gentlemen, that agriculture producers are perishable. When it loses its quality, it loses its value. The tourism sector is a big market alone for agriculture in Fiji. But what do we do when there are no cold storage systems? We have good vegetables in Nandrau. And I was in Batuman a few days ago on Wednesday. Our rural communities can produce very good quality vegetables for our local markets. But there's no cold storage systems. Pack houses, proper post-harvest handling infrastructure, let alone transportation, and the list goes on. This is a challenge, and you would notice that in the budget this year we have two separate allocations for cold storage facilities, and of course for agro processing facilities as well, because food products, they have very high standards. HACCP and other standards, you are all aware of this. We need to meet the standards. And that's another big problem, is the capacity of the farmers. Perhaps this is the biggest challenge for agriculture in Fiji. And this is why, for me, being here today is so important, because I'm trying to convince people like you to invest in the agriculture sector. Because the reality in Fiji today, the majority of our farmers are smallholder subsistence farmers. Agriculture, ladies and gentlemen, requires a lot of capital. But unfortunately, with most of our smallholder farmers, they don't even save enough so that they can reinvest into the business. Farming as a business. So one, it's the majority of our farmers are smallholder farmers. Only a small number are semi-commercial and are operating at the commercial level. But what are we doing now? In the last 3 years, we are working with FAO to do a rural and agriculture household statistics for Fiji, where we have categorized our farmers, and then we can come up with the right interventions too for the farmers in these areas. Absence of technology. We need to bring in technology. We are experiencing dry weather now. But most of the vegetables and the lettuces are dying simply because there is no irrigation. We need to bring best practices. What are the technologies that are available that we need to? And of course, genetic materials and others as well. So these are some of the challenges that we face in the agriculture sector that we need to address immediately so that we can meet the expectations of government on the sector. Market, let me talk very quickly about the market. I'm just speaking of the convictions of my heart. Let me just quickly touch on the market very quickly. Again, this is perhaps I've said very quickly that unfortunately we will produce a deal. And I always say to the Honorable PM, and unfortunately for agriculture in Fiji, for a long time we were doing a lot of wrong things well. Because you, as businessmen and women, agree that every activity undertaken in the sector must be driven by demand. Demand should dictate production. But unfortunately, for a long time, we were focusing on production and hoping that somebody in the end is going to come and buy the produce. We are changing that totally. We have been doing aggressive market research. We are looking at the new market segments where we need to penetrate on, and this goes with where we are flying our national airline now. We are looking at what are the potentials for us in Singapore, what are the potentials for us in Hong Kong, what are the potentials for us in Tokyo and Japan, Australia, America, all these new destinations. But yet, the domestic market alone is big. I've talked about smallholder farmers. You know, a sad story about smallholder farmers in Fiji? Their understanding of the market is the municipal council market next to them. That's the market. For someone in this area, it's just the Nadi and the Mako market. For us in Telemu, it's only the Korho market. Korho is going to be the fourth city of the Nadi. What we're trying to do now is aggressively doing this market research and, of course, organizing these farmers' groups into markets. We've talked about smallholder farmers as we've looked at it as a weakness for a long time, but we are trying to convert that into a strength by organizing them into farmers' groups. Whether we will call it clusters or whether we will call it cooperatives or whatever name we give them. Because we are to address three critical areas. One is the reliability and consistency in supply. Two is volume, and three is quality. Because we have a lot of smallholder farmers. They plant when they want to plant. And they decide what they plant, not according to what the market wants. We are trying to make them, although some of them will remain small, but as long as they are market-oriented, driven by demand. We are organizing them into groups so that these 10 farmers here in front will give us a tons rather than a few kilos, so that the buyer can come straight into the barn, into the farm, and buy at farm gate. And we organize the collection systems when we have these cold storages, whatever. I'm not going a lot with logistics. I'm just rushing through, ladies and gentlemen, because I know that in the program you will have urban agriculture, and you will have commercial agriculture, and maybe I'll be available to answer some questions as well. So this is what we're trying to do in organizing these farmers, but let alone the semi-commercial and the commercial operators. We are trying to organize them better so that hopefully in the end we will start contracting farmers to provide for each of the markets that we have identified. And when we're talking about these markets, the domestic demand in Fiji alone is big. Right now we are working with the private sector, the tourism sector, Peter G of GPH, Meliki and the team from British American Tobacco, and Karu from Max Value. And so we are forming up a team so that we bring in the private sector experience and their organizational skills and market information and whatever, so that we can organize the agriculture sector better. But let me just conclude very quickly by saying that I've talked about the challenges that we have. I'm just urging those of you in the room today, we need a lot of investment in the agriculture sector. The Reserve Bank has created the environment for that, and of course government as well. There are a lot of tax-free regions already organized. But we need people like Adish to come back into the agriculture sector, because Adish has got a lot of money. Because for us to
take agriculture to the next level, as I've stated very quickly, we'll organize the smallholder farmers, make them market-oriented, but as a group they remain strong, but we need a lot of intervention at the semi-commercial and the commercial level. And that requires some investment. Government is creating the environment. I hope that we will work together through partnerships so that we can move the sector forward. I'll stop here now because there will be other speakers, but I'll be happy to discuss this further with you. Thank you indeed for your attention.